You see Jewish Space Laser, my Jewish Space Laser membership. It's very secret, but I'm showing it specially for you. I'm doing whatever I can. Do you see that?
Yeah, I do.
My hands and all that.
Yeah.
So this is how I've been lecturing. I've been just using lots of old pens we used to use on the plastic transparencies to say, well, that if you have a one-dimensional chain, you have in red a field at the sides. If there is a symmetry reflection on the axis, there are two ways of doing it, either on the lattice side or half between lattice sides. That's how my lectures tend to be.
When you're teaching a graduate course, do you have any ideas for doing assignments that are more interesting than ordinary homework assignments that they hand in? Anything that's a bit more interactive that the students do in pairs, and they do presentations? Or
in group theory course, I haven't done it. You know, I do it always in nonlinear dynamics, but group theory course is very boring and very personal. It's kind of thing you figure yourself and write it down. I find it hard to share it live. Now, of course, we should encourage them to work in groups. So the rule is always work in groups, write your own solution. But I've been boring, you know, I've been just doing ordinary solutions, almost no numerical work. I mean, there's some simulations you can do, but mostly it's not worth using students' time for it.
Another thing I was thinking of, for example, you could have the students in pairs present their solutions.
I feel time is very precious, especially on this pandemic format. Time goes very fast because it's hard to do it efficiently.
Yeah.
So I've been really monopolizing the time. Mm-hmm. And if I would ask students to do something, it would be part of a lecture, and or Prolin said that illuminates the lecture, but some kind of very, you know, sharp format, mm-hmm. not reformat, because I feel we don't have time at all. And this summer is going to be hell because we are doing a semester, you know, it's at 2/3 of the time we cover the semester. You know, I'm kind of reactionary in group theory. Depends on the subject. You know, they're just calculations you have to do. And most people do it better in a dark room left to themselves than having to be disturbed by somebody else. Combinatorial thinking is very non-collective. It's really personal how people do it. I find it very difficult. I'm a visual person. I find it very difficult to think in linear algebraic way. I really have to be undisturbed to be able to go through it. In a pictorial situation, you know what the answer is a priori, and you just have to kind of bumble yourself to it, but not in group theory. So Han, do you have a calculation?